Hello one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play Empyrion Galactic Survival with me, EkkiThump. Back here on our base on Akua, what are we doing this session? I think I'm kind of tempted to get started on a capital ship, but I would like a few more levels of XP. You can see we've got the level. We're now at somewhere between level 12 and 15, which gives us most of what we need for a reasonable capital ship. One thing we can't access yet is the CV repair bay. But we should be in a position to start laying a design down, at the very least. Like, we've got the higher tier fuel tanks and stuff, so that gives us a bit more space to work with, because there's a limit on the number of blocks you can have now, and to get around that, you have, like, instead of having two tier 1 fuel tanks, you have one tier 2 fuel tank. And that kind of thing, and there's like large O2 tanks and all that kind of stuff. But we are not particularly rich on materials yet, especially on the Z and E, the materials for the power coils. So I would like to finish mapping out what's on this planet and on the moon, and maybe we can even track down our freighter. So I think what we're going to do is continue exploring until we're satisfied that we've found everything there is. Then we'll see how much we can actually invest into a cap ship design, because there's no point spending an entire episode designing a cap ship and then we come here and, oh, like, we need, you know, 50, 100 Arestrum, let's say, and we can't afford that. Plus, if we do a bit more dicking around in space, we'll get some more power coils off the drones that spawn there, which is all to the good. So we're going to start off with some ammunition. I'm going to put some things I don't need away. And I think it's going to be back into the little cricket. And we're going to finish mapping the surface of Akua. Then we're going to get up into space. If we can find a freighter, we'll fight a freighter. If not, we'll go to Akua Moon and start seeing if anything's changed up there. So that sounds like a plan to me. Right, we should be fairly well armed. We've got lots of food. I've refilled the oxygen tanks already, and there's a bunch of white O2 bottles still in the cargo bays. We want to check the fuel just before we go. Fuel tank. Pretty good, pretty good. Okay. Put this ammo in the ammo box. Rockets, Gatling gun ammo. Get locked and loaded. And there we go. So we've got 13 salvos. That is the right word, isn't it? Salvo. Now that I say salvo, it sounds really weird. It sounds more like a topical cream, but I'm pretty sure that is what I mean, a salvo of missiles. Fuck, you know, that's one of, you know, when words just go weird in your head, and all of a sudden you think, what, chin, is that a real word? It's that, but I'm pretty sure salvo is a real word, and it's the appropriate word, yes. So, 13 salvos of missiles. Anyway, we're not going to bother exploring Akua. Having uncovered all the resources on this planet, that usually means we've uncovered all or most of the POIs, so I don't think we'll find anything particularly new. So what we want to do instead is head directly into space. Now, this could of course go terribly wrong. If we do find a freighter and it outmatches us. But in theory we have a plan, don't we? We track it down. We take out the engines, take out the guns, get in there, give them the business, steal all their stuff, come home. Sounds easy. I'll bet it's not. But our main target is Akua Moon, I suppose. Which is a sort of... how do you even define over there? But over there. That white thing there. That's Akua Moon. That's where we're going. So I was going through the single player missions, because obviously we've skipped through a lot of the starter stuff. I've picked a mission that we can do on the moon, We can destroy a Ghost Rider base. I have some ammunition for the guns. So, if we go to the moon, find a Ghost Rider base, we should be able to take it on and fly home with some lovely loot. I'm curious what the reward is, because it doesn't tell you what the reward is for doing these missions. Single player missions, by the way, for anyone who doesn't know, you press F1, you go into the PDA, and you've got tutorials, and then here you've got single player missions. So we've clicked on the title bar here for No Man on the Moon, and gone down here to activate the mission. And our target is to destroy one Ghost Rider base on either Aqua or Omicron Moon. I guess they don't appear on Masperon Moon, even though you start there, so maybe that's a different faction. But here we go. You can sort of tell where the fishnet's going to be because of that weird like pinched effect on the pole there. So we are heading a bit away from the fishnet. When you're getting close, actually, well, you used to be able to see it from space. I don't know if you still can. But actually, if I just fly over here for a minute, yeah, that's the edge of the fishnet there. Oh, Jesus. Actually, we're not... Are we going to be able to slow down? Right, we still need to work on our maneuverability, don't we? So, there's the line of the orange fishnet. And here is what it's protecting. So, all that around it is like normal space. Like just normal hills and valleys and whatnot. Here is a very weird sawtooth line where the two join up, and this kind of pinched, crazy looking mountain range. And basically, they want to keep you away from that. They don't want you breaking your immersion on it. So that's why the fishnet's there. It must be possible to fix that. Like to randomly generate believable terrain on a sphere. They don't seem all that bothered about fixing it just yet, but one would guess it's on their list of things to do at some point. It is a bit, that must be a bit weird for someone who, obviously having I've played Empyrion, this is like my fifth playthrough and my second let's play of it, but for someone coming to it for the first time, that would be really weird, just having a sudden barrier at the edge of the map. But hey ho. Now then, we don't really know where we're going. Anything could be anywhere on the planet, so what we're going to do is just, as normal, point north and slightly west and just drift along until we find something. Now there should be something around here somewhere. Drones don't just spawn randomly. They are protecting stuff normally, especially three of them. But it could be off left, it could be off right, it could be anywhere. It's probably that. We're looking for, obviously, materials in general, but a Ghost Rider base in particular. The fuck? A residential complex. Okay, we've got to check that out, haven't we? Helmet's on. Oh, I need to get my O2 canisters. Oh, fuck. Jesus. There is still a bug in the game where if you're moving the mouse as you open inventories, it seems to be, you like cancel the opening. And then obviously you left click and fire your gun and waste a bunch of ammunition that you didn't want to waste. But yeah, I need to, because we're on the moon, obviously, as you'd expect, we can't breathe, so I need to take my O2 bottles with me. I think they're in here, yeah. Four should be enough. And we're going to have a quick whiff from the O2 station. Oh, I need to... Right, we need to turn the power on. There we go. If you're standing on top of a vehicle, you can press Y and turn it on and off. You don't actually need to go inside it. Now these, I'm going to grab these. These you may be familiar with, but these are pentaxide crystals, and these are the raw material that you process into warp drive fuel. And basically, it's one pentaxide per one astronomical unit, or it was. Obviously, I haven't warp jumped since last Let's Play, so you never know, it may have changed. But the moons are a really good source for them, because they just, yeah, as you can see, they're just lying out here in the open. You can get them on Akua, but they're at the bottom of lakes, and it's a bit of a pain in the ass. It's better to wait, if honestly, until you can fly to the moon and get them. Because you're going to be able to fly to the moon before you're going to need to warp anywhere, aren't you? Let's be honest. Also, note the range of the weapons on the moon, because there's no, at well, there's very little atmosphere anyway. The pistol now shoots out to 103 meters instead of, what is it, 67, 69? And even this crappy tier 1 sniper rifle has a range of 200 meters. It's something to bear in mind when you're taking on drones as well, because they can shoot you from much further away. Now, this residential POI is new to me. I've not seen one of these before, so let's go and have a look around. Is there glass here? Oh, I bet it's sealed, isn't it? We've got company again. You've really got to pay attention to what's coming in, because they can shoot stuff from so far away. You get a lot less time to react because of the increased shooting distance, because the radar doesn't get any increased range. And we have had troubles before with stuff blowing up because drones have shot it, haven't we? Which one was I looking at? I don't know. Let's just go and start from over here. So it looks like the same sort of residential unit design. Oh, it's a sandwich. Sandwich. I'm just going to eat that straight away. Because if you find food like that, it's generally worth just eating it straight away if you've got room on your food bar. Because it's going to spoil before... By the time you actually need food, it's going to have spoiled. Nice. Is that it? There's a thing over here as well. We're still not dipping into the emergency rations at all, despite being in effectively survival mode. We did well getting our farm online just at the right time. Plus we found an absolute shitload of free food, didn't we? With all those outposts we came across. Bandages. Effective against open wounds. Veggie burger, that's quite nice. So we've got spare, yeah, so we can't eat any more food, we'll take it anyway. It's going to end up as like spoiled food. We'll just try and remember that we've got it, so we eat that instead of the canned stuff. I don't know if I ever showed it, but canned veggies, and we've been carrying these around for quite a while. Perish time 324. Spare ribs, which we've just picked up fresh out of a fridge. Perish time 24, it was 25. Have I been in here? Yeah, I have, haven't I? Got runes left and right. There's lots of cargo pods here, which is nice. We should get some useful stuff. Now, I don't think there was anything in those fridges on Akua. I'm not sure if that's been patched in, that food's... fridges will now spawn food, or do like POIs in quote-unquote harder places, which the moon would technically count as, I suppose, drop better stuff. Look at this, we don't need all these stomach pills. The only thing stomach pills are good for is curing food poisoning, and you only get food poisoning by eating like raw vegetables, essentially, that you've plucks out of the ground, which we're not going to be doing anymore. So why am I even keeping stomach pills? It's just that hoarding instinct. You know, you want to keep everything just in case it's useful, even if it isn't ever going to be useful, like fucking cement blocks. Cement blocks you can't even use to upgrade with. You have to use bags of cement, but still, if I find a cement block and I've got space to carry it, I'm taking it with me. Okay, we could go for an oxygen recharge. One thing, never underestimate how many canisters you're going to need to carry. One stack of O2 canisters does not fill your oxygen bar. It gives you about a half or two thirds. It's something to be wary of. I think we're pretty much done with this place. Did we look in there? Yeah, we've been in there. So that was basically some free loot. That was a nice place to start. It's not a Ghost Rider base though, so we don't get to see the quest rewards just yet. Oh, one thing I'll say as well, obviously, handy hint, if you want to access the cargo box in your ship and you've got a full inventory, do it while standing on top of the ship. Because once you're piloting the ship, all of these things that have been forced into the hotbar over here, you can't access them. I've only got 3 door bombs left. I should have made some more of those. We'll have to make it work. We've got plenty of ammo. We'll have to shoot stuff. Anything else I can afford to drop off? I want to keep the perishable food with me, like this bread. I guess we'll take the mule milk. It's a shame to use the mule milk just as food, because it's a component in some of the nicer recipes. But we'll never get it home in time. We haven't got a fridge on the craft. You can get vehicle-mounted fridges if you want to do like serious, long away missions, but we're not going that far from home, really. We are going, like, the moon is literally not that far from home in this game. And neodymium as well. You can also get neodymium on the moon. Neodymium is mostly useful for advanced CPUs. And Irestrium and Zascosium are mostly used for power coils. In one sense, very limited use materials, but you do need them in quite large numbers to make things like capital ships. Because all of the stuff you want to put on a capital ship, a lot of it uses power coils, uses advanced CPUs, and even like tier 2 weapons you need sometimes a few CPUs and coils for. What is it to make flux coils? I think that might be neodymium as well, possibly. See, you don't learn the recipes for the components in this game, because you always just use the advanced constructor to do it. Now, though, we might have a bit of a rumble on over here. Is that a Ghost Rider base? Looks hopeful. Oh, it's the drone base. Let's just try and run away from it. We'll come back for it, but I want a Ghost Rider base. That's what I want to hunt down this episode. There's no reason to preserve the drone base on this planet, because we're not going to be farming drones here. Or maybe we should. Maybe we could take out the drone base on Akua so our base doesn't get attacked, and then if we want to farm drone poop, we can come here. Let's swing further away from it. Either way, we're not killing it here. There's another potential point of interest, the crashed ship. I thought it was supposed to be your ship. It's actually one of your fleet that crashed into the moon. Empyrion does have a backstory. So, basically the story of the game is, as always, Earth is a screwed up industrial shithole, dying, and like you're the... You've been sent out on a colony mothership as the kind of the last hope of humanity, looking for a star system that you learned about through aliens, named Empyrion, and somehow you've wandered off course and ended up crash landing on Akua. And that's the backstory of the game. You are the last hope of humanity, but you're not where you're meant to be. Are they going to expand on that in the future? I don't know. It would be cool if you could actually go and find Empyrion. I suppose that comes under, like, because they've got this solar system that you're in now, and I really would like it if there was a procedural galaxy. But that's, you know, at one point I was certain that that was a thing that they were supposed to be adding to the game. At this point I'm wondering if I imagined that, because I can't seem to find any reference to it. But I think that would be a cool feature to the game, because, you know, you start Empyrion and you bounce around the same 8 or 9 planets, and you can insert modded planets into the game as well. And a lot of people do that in, like, their, especially when doing Let's Plays. But I think it's nice not to know what's out there, because if you add a modded planet, you know, there's no surprise factor there. You know what you're getting yourself in for. And once you play through the game a few times, you know, you go to Maspron, you go to Aestis or Ningguez, you know what's waiting for you there. You know, and apart from, like, this Let's Play, where there's been several huge patches since I last regenerated the galaxy, it's just nice in space games in particular to have that random generation. That's sort of a little bit of a roguelike aspect to it, maybe. But yeah, that's something that is, may or may not be coming up. I don't know. It's something I really would like to see, though. Hopefully after they fix the bloody fishnets. Speaking of. If we come back round to the same fucking place. Is that the entire moon? We've not found a single Ghost Rider base. Drone base. Crashed ship. Oh, Jesus. Must have done something wrong. There's nothing here. There's fucking nothing here. There's no Ghost Riders on the moon. There's a crashed ship, a drone base, and this residential complex. That is the worst moon I've ever seen. I think to do that quest, we're going to have to go to Omicron. Alright, well, let's not completely waste the trip to the moon. Let's go. Do you know what? Forget this idea of farming drones. Let's go and take on the moon drone base. You do want to fight something. Oh, blinded. Got to get those sun visors down. Jesus, this place is fucking heavily defended. Missed completely. Fuck you. Don't kill me, bro. Fuck's sake. Well, we got one of the green turrets down. That's a good start. And there goes a reddent. We hit it. We did not take it out. Okay, there goes another one. We're definitely taking shots. There might be some sentry turrets down there as well. We are running out of rockets. Oh shit, fucking hell. That didn't sound good, did it? Ow, Jesus Christ. Holy shit in balls. Right. God dear. Where are those shots coming from? I can probably track those down. Oh Jesus, there's a load of sentry cannons there as well. What the hell is shooting at me there? Oh dear. Okay, well, we seem to be still flying and still breathing. Let's take an inventory of what exploded. Hell's teeth. Anything missing? We've lost a rocket launcher. That's all. Jeez, there's going to be some repair work for the repair bay to do when we get back to base. Oh shit. No! You fucker. Okay, we can't respawn back at base. We're gonna have to respawn near our corpse somewhere. What a disaster. Yeah, we can't spawn on our home base. We've got to respawn over here somewhere. Can you hear those fuckers inside? Can't even... There we go. Oh shit, what? How's that a thing? I've got to take out the pissing sentry turret before I can even pick up my backpack. There you go. Holy shit. I've honestly never known that happened before. I didn't even know that the sentry turrets could shoot your drone. Oh, wait, there's another one. Oh, is that a turret bot actually? It might be. Okay, death count 2. All of it in this episode. Oh, piss off. Shit, there's fucking bad guys up there, aren't there? There's another sentry turret in there. If we hug the ground, we might be okay. Damn it. And now there's a minigun drone coming in. Cock-a-leaky. There's two minigun drones coming in. Can I get an angle here? Got that. Okay, is that everything now? Can I finally pick up my backpack? Okay, we're gonna health up. We're gonna O2 up. And we're gonna eat some ribs. Whew. That was an experience. So in this mode, sentry turrets are serious business. There's still some on the outside of the base. The other side of the base is covered in sentry turrets. We've got to be very careful where we step. Actually, I don't even care what's in that drone. Okay, I think we have to be a little bit sneaky and see what's in there. There's another there's another turret on the wall over there. Are we clear to approach on this side even? Yeah, we can. What we could do is try and blow that turret up from behind. Is it even clear around this side? There's nothing there. Oh! Oh, you fucking... Oh my god. Excuse me? really want to use the ship to get in there, but we don't even have any ammo left for it. Best I can do is just try and cover myself. These guys are pretty fucking insane in this mode as well. We can't even afford to let that rocket drone be lurking around out here. I think we're going to have to ignore that. My god. Okay, we can't even get in close enough to stick a bomb down. We're running low on health kits. I've never felt fucking less prepared for a mission in Empyrion than I feel for this one. Holy shit, Jesus Christ. Okay, well we can... that turret was over here somewhere, so we could try and go in from above. That barely made a fucking dent in the ceiling. We're gonna have to go home. We do not have enough power to do this. We can't even make a fucking hole in the roof. Is this even doing any damage to the roof? I think I can check with my multi-tool. It's doing a bit, but we need like six more of those to get through. Having said that, we can probably knock out this one. No, that did no damage to it. Shit. Okay, we just need more power to get through here. We're not going to get in there. It's too well defended, especially with that, with a sentry turret putting at the door and bad guys spawning like right there. The only other option is to try and go in at this end. But I don't think there's a door here. Oh. Those are windows. Oh! We're taking shots from something inside. I think a turret locked onto us. Well, we're definitely going home now because we're out of health items. Yeah, it's a tactical retreat, I think. We know where the base is. What we need to do is go home, health up, get some more bombs. More bombs, more ammo. I don't even know if I've got any more health items or the makings for them. Maybe I've got some alien plasma. But I mean, Jesus, if we're struggling like this with the Aqua Moon drone base, God only knows what we're going to be dealing with when we get to the fortress. Okay, well, we've managed to limp home. How about you fix up all my shit, please, repair bay? And the repair bay is like, fucking hell, I hope I'm getting paid overtime for this. Okay, well, that wasn't actually too bad. It's quite quick at fixing things. Right, we're missing a rocket launcher. That's the only thing we lost. So I'm quite happy with the way the cricket is performing in and of itself in base assaults. Could do with being a little bit nippier. Maybe we'll put on a couple of side thrusters just to give ourselves a bit of a bit more lateral thrust in the air, give us a bit more ability to dodge the firepower. But that was a fairly decently defended base in terms of the number of turrets it had, and we performed okay from the air. We need to start taking a lot more explosives with us on these away missions to give ourselves a few more like tactical options. We need to start turning our jetpack on, so as not to suicide off the roof. We definitely learned something. I was not aware that sentry turrets could pop your drone now. So, but it doesn't matter too much. We are quite safe, although it does mean we may struggle to retrieve the backpack. We need more explosives. Possibly, even this playthrough, we might want to play around with the tactical rocket launcher, which does 180 damage. It doesn't say how much these things do. I don't know, what do you think? Does it look... I don't know how to judge whether that's going to be good. I guess we'll try one out and see how it does, I guess. But we need to take a lot more rockets. We need to take a lot more door bombs. And we need to farm up some ZR1 plasmas to start making health kits. Because we're really short of that. So we need to go out wandering, I think. But... Alright, well, I've been recording for way too long at this point, so I'm afraid I'm going to have to cut it there. Next time, we'll go in, rearmed, reloaded, ready to rock and roll, and we'll have our revenge. That was just a probing attack. The main assault comes next episode. For now, I've been EkkiThump, and that was Let's Play Empyrion Galactic Survival. Hope you enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game. And I will see you next time.